All right, everyone, welcome to TFPG Spring Tournament for 2015. I am your host, Montclair. Co-casting with me tonight will be Sprout Salad. This is the Parish. This is the final game in this final Swiss round. We will be having the teams of the Squid Squad versus the Coalition of Cool Kids. Captains for the teams, respectively, are Ramirez and Cygnus. And Sprout, how are you doing this evening, sir?
I'm doing very well. How are you?
Very well.
Exceptionally well, in fact.
And
I haven't been this well in some time.
Excellent. These names that they've got now in chat are going to be very difficult for us to call. I'm going to have to ask them to get that stuff off of there. Look how this is showing up on the HUD. It's impossible to know who's who.
Pimp. Just calling them all pimp. Denied.
Alright then. Okay. So again, here we are. We're actually readying up. We are ready to go with this right away. First hit's going to be a Smoker, Spitter, Hunter, and Boomer. And team Coalition Cool Kids up first as Survivor. We've got a Smoke going out immediately on Ellis, setting up for a Death Charge, but there's no Charger. Hunter landing also, so good damage here. Actually, nice attack by Ramirez, a Squid Squad. But not too awful much damage there. A little bit on Cygnus.
Don't be mad at me, Mom. But you're a jockey on my screen.
Your thoughts on that hit, Sprout?
I think you're a jockey.
I think I just missed. Back a million times. Okay.
There we go.
Reload!
So a nice take there by Coalition of Cool Kids. Coalition of Cool Kids' initial mentor was Jacob. He was unable to continue in the tournament and has been replaced by Cygnus, who graciously stepped in and offered to enter the team for this, most likely, their final match.
Cygnus mentored last tournament, right?
Cygnus was actually my mentor in the last tournament. Did a great job. I have nothing bad to say about him. Next hit coming up here. We've got a Smoke going on in the back, along with this Boomer getting a nice double of, actually a single Boomer and a proxy. More damage being doled out to Coalition Cool Kids. But the tank is now up in the hands of Grim. Let's take this over to an infected war room.
And then you go over here, and then you like throw a rock.
This is new meta.
This is new meta, bro.
You want a Boomer, right?
Yeah.
Get that Smoker, quick.
Alright.
Try not to take chip here.
Alright.
Alright, you're good.
I'm gonna be second pass.
Yeah, that's fine. Ooh. Close. Try to take sight. Hold up, Brennus is
take in sight.
Five. Take sight.
Take sight, Padawan.
You ready?
Take the sight from them. Mm-hmm. You got a spawn Boomer?
Yeah.
Alright.
Yeah.
Alright, go.
I'm going.
Do your thing. Nice. So? Get that Boomer.
What? Okay. There you go.
Oh.
Okay.
What's up, boss?
Tim, help me. Where are you guys?
Get out after that. If you can.
I'm down.
Charger. Ooh. Oh shit.
Those poles are hacking.
That's fine, you got it down.
No, I...
And we are back. So some tank play there by Grim, able to get it down on Cygnus. Remaining survivors able to escape relatively unscathed. So unfortunately, not so great there for Squid Squad, but again, early on here in the map. Nice try there.
Tank, when he committed, he'd already taken significant amounts of chip, and so I made his job a lot harder committing. And then it was a single boom, but I don't think it was enough, unfortunately. And Grim's strength is also hittable tanks. I know he much prefers dumpster or car to play with.
Agreed. Oh, I'm in bad position here. And there's an attack going out. We've got a hunter along with some spit, a little bit of smoke, a smoke with a little bit of spit as well. I believe the witch was crowned during that. I was not in position to get it on camera, so we missed that,
well. That. She's definitely dead, though. That's for sure.
Survivors now making their way into the safe room. Charger spawning in, actually causing the survivors to trip that alarm car, but it's going to be too little too late here. And the Coalition Cool Kids have made it into the safe room with a tremendous health bonus here, racking up a score of 848 points for round one, or map one. Nice job.
That's really strong work from them. They killed the tank and then moved past all the hits extremely quickly. I think there was only one proper hit like between the tank and the safe room, and then a couple where the SI sort of trickled in. Ineffectually.
Yeah, tank, at least for Grim's tank, though, he missed a couple of punches there. One of the survivors actually hopped over him on the railing in the corner. And really just some good play there by the Cool Kids handling that tank.
There's a little gallery of sprays in the safe room right now. It's like a little art exhibit.
Temporary art.
What a bunch of bullshit.
Please don't mince words, Sprout. How do you really feel?
I am not a fan of modern art. And that's not modern art. That's nothing. This is pictures of Goku.
Waiting for me to ready up here, and match is now going live. For our first attack, we're going to have a boomer, smoker, hunter, spitter, and then a tank. No death charge potential here, obviously, with no charger. We have not seen a death charge in this map, and here comes the attack. Smoker pulling for the hunter. Hunter lands on Ellis, and spit goes out onto Ramirez, team mentor. So he took the bulk of the chip there, and that attack, 16 HP down on Ramirez.
Didn't really amount to much, luckily for him. Reloading.
Survivors progressing, trying to get this tank up. We'll probably see them work their way back as well.
They're gonna run into a hit here, so this is a good opportunity for the SI to make something happen.
Hunter coming in, getting skeeted right away. Jockey now in as well. Boomer with a beautiful tri-boom. Charger coming in. Oh, this does not look good for the Squid Squad. This tank is gonna come in on this, and there is a down on Rochelle. Gonna go for another down. This will definitely, I would have. I think anyway, be a kill on Rochelle, and that's tough. Brightness is now dead, so that is going to give the win more than likely here for this round to the Coalition of Cool Kids. Squid Squad electing to move forward here, and not waiting out the tank. Probably going to be making a run for it. They are, in fact. Here comes a boomer, maybe to try and slow them down. Boomer is out of position, not able to get that boom. And let's go ahead and go to. An infected worm, and here the rest of this tank played out.
Let's fall back. Nice!
Oh,
Charlie Brown, it's okay. Just play goalie. Don't let him through you, Luke.
You're doing a good job, Luke. Go off.
Ah, shit. I just punch him.
Oh,
And that, ladies and gentlemen, was a infected war room.
Good job, Luke.
Brought to you by Luke.
Good job, Luke. And there you have it, Luke touting his own skills for everyone to hear. And that was a very nice tank played by Luke. And have a look at that here on the instant replay. You can see Luke getting Team Captain Ramirez down here, or at least on the run, chasing after him. Going to land a punch here. I think he's going to land another rock. I don't actually, Charger came in and handled that. And Luke getting the wipe. So nice job by Luke. We'll be back with the rest of the round in a minute.
Frying pan. Yeah.
You good, Sprout? Am I looking all right to you on your HUD?
Sorry, I was AFK. What happened?
My question is, are you all set with the HUD before we get this going here?
On my screen, you are currently two boomers, three jockeys, okay, and a tank. But otherwise, I'm good.
Okay, round is going live here. We have a score of 848 points for Cygnus Coalition of Cool Kids to Ramirez's the Squid Squad at 241. Our first attack will consist of a boomer, charger, jockey, and smoker.
This is a good opportunity to get some early damage here. It is a 2-2, but they have a charger, and if I get my spec HUD up, I can see there is also a jockey.
The underdogs have taken a 600-point lead here in this match, so everybody bet on them. Good for you. Here comes the attack. Charger missing his charge. Boomer getting M2'd before he's able to actually get any vomit out. Gets a proxy boom. Jockey was M2'd shut down as well as that smoker. So not too much damage going out. Nice take there by the Coalition of Cool Kids.
And this is a pretty good tank spawn, I think, for the Coalition right now, because being in the lead, they probably want to get those late tanks, not have anything spawning too early. And this tank, is this actually after the event? 84? That's pretty late.
Yeah, that is awfully late. That may be during. I don't know. Be close to the end.
If it is during, it's going to be right at the end, the tail end of the horde.
Our next hit is up here, consisting of a charger, hunter, boomer, and jockey. SI electing to wait for survivors to progress a little further in the map.
Everybody grab a weapon.
We're going to go for that arc boom over the top there. And here he comes, able to connect on Nick. Nice single boom there. Jockey going in after Ramirez, I believe. Or after Cygnus, excuse me. Hunter lands on Nick. And Boomer coming in for a proxy again on Nick.
I think the Boomer landed on Nick there, and he was instantly surrounded by Common and taking some damage. I think the Hunter actually gave him a couple of God Frames there and prevented him from taking more scratches.
Machete here.
Cricket bat here.
Yeah, I'll take a shot.
Survivor's doing a pretty good job here shutting down the attacks, not taking a lot of damage. They're in pretty good shape here for this event. All pills, all permanent health. We have the witch up at, I don't know where. Is she done already?
She's on the other side of the trailer, so they can pull her through the fence if they want to, but then they have to be careful of spawns dropping on top of them from the bridge above.
See if they elect to do that now. It looks like they're going to try to maybe get another hit. Nope, they are drawing the witch. And here she comes, hopefully, to progress towards them, and no. Climbing fences is difficult, which has now figured it out. Here comes the SI hit, and Smoker gets shut down right away. And what a great crown there by Luke, actually pulling that crown off and getting jockeyed immediately. Fortunately, Coach taking a lot of damage there with a charge and spit. But nice crown there by Luke.
That was a nice crown, and the witch obviously didn't land a hit or anything, but the SI managed to get some good damage anyway with the spit there. So survivors softened up a little bit for the event and the following tank.
And let's go, let's go! Right or right, gotta keep moving!
We have a pullback.
There's a pullback on Nick. And Hunter covering, unfortunately, a little bit late. So he gets shut down, but more spit damage going out on Coach. And now separated by spit from the rest of her teammates.
Empathy. It was a bit of an unlucky spread on the spit there. Was it Coach? Yeah, so Coach was pounced, and the spit puddle kind of stretched not very far beyond her. So as soon as she got up, she managed to walk out of it without taking any more ticks of damage.
A lot of survivor separation here. They're starting to group up again. Our next hit is going to be up here. We have got a jockey, spitter, smoker, and charger. SI jockeying for position.
No pun intended.
Yes. And here comes the attack. Charger going and misses his charge completely. Smoke getting a nice separation there. Jockey unable to land on Luke, getting M2 shut down. Smoker still going on. Not cleared yet. A lot of damage here going out on Nick. And that is a down. Nice smoke. Unfortunately, Luke not able to get through all of that horde. So that
and
is.
Rochelle, as soon as Nick went down there, Rochelle stepped forward a little bit and spawned the tank. So that luckily they got Nick up in time. Otherwise, that could have been very bad.
Oh, and here's a boomer spawning up, trying to get a boom, but it's not going to happen. Gets M2'd and not able to get that boom off. Tank maybe committing here. Let's go ahead to an infected war room. And I hear the Squid Squad play out their tank.
Gonna hit? I wait for a
minute. Save. Alright. Oh, there's still a horde. If you want to go in now.
Yeah, I kinda wanna go in.
That's why I get this sword.
Things are black in my life.
Alright.
I'll get the charge. Alright, nice. Holy moly. Help her. Yeah.
Nice charge.
There's still a lot of horde. This guy's down, so don't even. Nice.
Are you so healthy? Look at that green thing.
So healthy.
Help me out! Oh no, you didn't get it. I don't like it. Oh, I
man.
Don't like it. I don't like
I
it.
I think they're hacking.
Okay, we got your head.
Decommit, decommit.
Okay, just
get yeah, help her, help her. Right.
Help, help!
Go, go, go.
I got one. Jockey, no!
I'm coming!
Jockey!
Oh!
Oh!
Fuck.
Go boom.
God.
Oh, that boom. What a
keep running, bro,
boom.
Keep running.
They're not getting that pickup. Oh!
Nice!
Didn't even
try
it.
Didn't even
break a sweat.
Anybody wanna lend me a hand here?
Just delay the pickup if you can.
Okay.
No. Oh!
That's it. Can't even spawn.
Alright. Still on first.
I'll take this one.
Well, boys, this looks like it for me.
You ready? Let's get our rock. Let's go, go.
You gotta charge.
Fuck. No! I faith. Close score.
You good? Good.
Dang, they found more pills or something?
Yeah, they left them back there.
Jeez.
Oh, I want to see this man.
It kills you. That'd be hilarious. Oh, they can move.
Nice. Oh, I'm lagging. Oh boy.
You good?
Yeah, okay, I'm okay.
Let's do it. Oh. Nice. Easy.
We are back there. What a great tank played by Ika and some great SI support there. We've got a kill on Luke. Every other survivor bleeding. Empathy currently down. No pills remaining. Here comes a jockey to troll that pickup. We've only got one survivor up. What a great double charge there. Nicely done. Only one survivor up at this moment, and that is Easy. Going to have to get both of his remaining teammates up and try and finish out the rest of this round, but not looking good for the Coalition of Cool Kids. What a great tank.
Yeah, superb tank, and Survivor's probably not going to get very much further. The Horde has stopped, but they have a dead person, a down, SIS still coming in, there's a pull, and there's the double cap for the wipe.
There it is. So unfortunately for the Coalition of Cool Kids, not able to get to the safe room. That tank expertly played by Aika. Some
she
great support.
A spectacular rock there after she
left. Yes.
She got out onto that roof and then landed an absolutely monster rock from extremely far away.
Take a look here at that awesome crown by Luke. Got to give him credit. Credit where credit is due. Pulling off that crown while jockeyed pretty much. So nicely done by Luke. Be back with the rest of the round and just... And we are back. Round is going live now. For our first hit, we're going to have a Jockey, Charger, Smoker, and Boomer. Rob, would you like to call this hit?
Nope.
Okay. Boomer coming in, gets M2'd, popped right away. Survivor's backing up into the safe room. We've got Charger spawned up already. Jockey on the roof. So nice bait there by the Squid Squad. Survivor's now committing, coming out of the room. Great charge and smoke. Nice double cap there. Beautifully done, and almost a try, but another double cap. Great attack there by the Coalition of Cool Kids, giving out a lot of damage to the Squid Squad, much more than they took.
Yeah, considering the Boomer got popped so early, that was really well done to get some damage anyway. I'm reloading. Coming up onto the corner here, but I think the SI were a little bit late setting up. So, well, they can still hit from the bathroom here, perhaps. Looks like they're setting up inside the bathroom.
Our next attack will be a Charger, Boomer, Jockey, Hunter. Hit is coming in. Charger gets shut down before he can do anything, but distracts nicely for a good try boom. Jockey does land as well as that Hunter, but cleared immediately. We're going to be looking for the Horde to try and pull out some damage here as a result of that boom. Otherwise, a nice take by the Squid Squad, shutting everything else down.
And the really good boom there is going to give the SI plenty of time to move up ahead, maybe get up on the bridge. We're probably going to see them set up for the Witch. I'm assuming survivors want to pull the Witch through the fence like Cool Kids did, just because she's in kind of a bad position there. If they went through, started the event, and maybe got capped by the Witch, that would be extremely bad for them.
We will see how they elect to play this Witch, more than likely the same way, just as you commented.
And indeed, we have the SI up on the bridge. None of them body zombies. And there's the pull.
Witch electing a different path this time. Let's see if she actually... She is heading in the right direction. And a nice double boom to come out and mess things up. Oh, and Witch going for Nick. Oh, and Nick gets the crown. Another beautiful crown. Contested by all the SI. Great job there by Team Mentor Ramirez.
See a similar kind of play happening here as we did on with the other team. The Witch did get crowned. However, while that was happening, two SI got caps. There was a boom, so plenty of damage went out despite the crown.
Turn off the alarm. Run! Driver's now activating the event. Standing in their way will be a Boomer, Jockey, Spitter, Charger, as long as that tank, well as that tank, excuse me. Reloading. Here comes the hit. Charger has spawned up, is able to land. Nice charge there. Not electing to go down the entire length of the corridor, as survivors more than likely expected. So a lot of damage there. Great job. We've got three sets of pills remaining, but we've got three survivors in full bleed. Tank, actually, we've got a little ways to go before this tank is up. One of the survivors actually pushed well ahead during one of the attacks in the other in the previous half of the round. Spawned that tank up. Reloading. Survivor's in pretty good shape to take this tank. They've got plenty of pills. Tank is now up in the hands of Empathy. We will take this over to an infected war room right now.
Alright, whatever you do, don't get chipped too much. Oh my god, nice! What was Grim thinking? Reloading here. Oh, don't lag now.
Nice.
That's good, that's good.
I'm coming back in for another smoke.
Just not guard that, don't take too much chip, okay? He's basically
oh,
dead.
I'm gonna pull Ramirez. Oh, no.
Wait.
He doesn't even know I'm here. I got another one if you.
I'm still on fire, why?
Game glitched.
No, don't kill me.
You have 40 seconds. Shoot it! I'm gonna get this boom nut.
Just don't. You need to get that boom on, Grim.
Where? Oh, there it is.
Man, fuck this game.
And we are back. I can see with the bugs in ProMod 4.3.1 is things remaining on fire when they should not be. And
I'm surprised they haven't said they haven't paused and asked to restart the round actually. And they could still do that. I mean, they probably should because that the tank died almost. Just because of the fire.
Yes,
there.
I agree. Not sure why Molly was reintroduced into ProMod, but it is buggy, in fact, still after this latest patch. Well, that is most unfortunate for Empathy, her tank getting killed more or less by a Molotov cocktail, and not anything to do with survivor play other than throwing that Molly. We've got a nice attack going out, though. On Brightness, she is down now as well with a jockey and some spit. We want only Aika with any permanent health here, so the Squid Squad is going to be making their way into the safe room with some bonus.
Oh, damn it.
You had a... Are you kidding me?
And a jockey coming in here, separating coaches. He tries to go in. Nice attack by Coalition of Cool Kids. And getting a pullback on Rochelle. This isn't over yet, folks. Nice attack, really chipping away at some more of the health. Coach finally getting into the room, and that is the end of the round. Most unfortunate, though, that tank due to that bug. We'll be back with the next round.
I really don't understand why they didn't ask for a restart. There is added, I don't know how many, like a couple hundred points at least in distance, and then another 80 in health bonus for Ramirez that they may not have gotten otherwise.
Taking a look again at that fantastic crown by Ramirez, just as good as Luke's, pulling that off with all the SI attacking him. And stay tuned. We'll be back with the next map right now. Round is going live here. For our first attack, we've got a Boomer, Smoker, Charger, Jockey. All the SI setting up on top of the overpass. Jockey committing now. Only Nick out of the safe room. Charger also committing, but he gets shut down right away. Smoker coming in and taking care of Nick. Beautiful tri-boom going out. So nice attack there, but nice take. Luke, the only one taking any appreciable damage from that attack.
Ah, man, I would be so annoyed if my tank got lit on fire through a bug. Actually, that happened to me in the previous version of Promont, but it was just a, I think it was a scrim or something. Still made me extremely mad, but I mean, this is a match.
Yeah, as it would anyone, of course. I mean, nobody likes to see the round or the gameplay affected by a bug, but you know, bugs are part of computer programming. That's the way it goes. We got a nice try cap, exceptional try cap. Only Rochelle up to clear everything. What a great hit!
Yeah, clearly the mishap of the last round there with Empathy's tank is not stopping them from pulling out all the stops here, getting a tri cap and a boom and massive damage all across the board there.
Actually, I believe that was Empathy's tank, wasn't it?
It was Empathy's tank, yeah.
Right, so they're actually just got tri cap.
Oh, wrong team.
Yes.
I lose. GG.
Maybe it is affecting them mentally. Probably upset about what went on with that tank and losing a little bit of focus. Probably discussing it, much like we are. But let's focus on the rest of this game. Everybody understands it's a bug. It happens. Nothing we can do about it now. It's done and gone. Rest of the attack is coming in. We have a Boomer getting a single boom. Smoker landing. Boomer coming in. Going to get a quad proxy. Nicely played by the Boomer. Survivor's taking a lot of damage here. Empathy and Bleed, remaining survivors down to half health, except for Team Mentor Cygnus.
That's really going to slow them down. They don't have tank for a little while yet, so they need to hold on to their health and their pills if they want any chance of making their tank. Is that a drop tank?
81,
no,
yes.
It is,
81?
It is? Okay. Well, either way, I think the tank can probably bleed the survivors out.
And here comes our next attack. Jockey going in along with a Hunter, getting a nice double cap in Spit. And Ellis running around in too. Well, not cap. That is a down on Coach. Great attack there by the Squid Squad. We've got Empathy down and Easy losing a lot of health in that attack somehow as well also. We've got only one set of pills remaining and only two survivors with any appreciable permanent health.
Easy managed to leap up onto the kitchen counter there and save the last remaining sliver of his health bonus there and didn't go down, but still ate a lot of Spit damage.
Boomer coming up out of the tunnel to get a single boon, probably sacking, looking for a spitter. Actually, we already have a spitter.
Yeah, they want something different for the choke point.
And survivors are dropping at least one of them.
Looks like SI want to set up on the top of the ladder. I know sometimes, especially recently, we've been seeing teams opting to attack this choke point from different directions, sometimes from below, sometimes from behind. We're going with a classic hit here, apparently.
Charger coming in, missing the charge. Spit is going to go down, and that's actually nerfed, so that's not going to do much. But in the back, we've got a smoker down there. He gets cleared, and 2SI still up on this. Charger is able to land. It's 2 pounds. Spitter coming out, getting some more damage on Luke. Which is up now. We'll be looking for Nick here. And he did fail that crown, unfortunately. That is a down on Easy. Now we only have Cygnus in it with any health bonus. Here comes a pullout on Rochelle, a jockey on Nick. And the Coalition Cool Kid's taking a lot of damage here.
Managed to, they managed to avoid setting off any car alarms there, which the jockey came extremely close to doing, dragging Nick towards that car.
Here's another attack. Boomer coming in, getting a boom on Ellis. Charger complimenting that, getting Ellis down. Nick there to try and keep whatever horde's coming in off of him and get the pickup. We've had some staggered spawns here. The SI trying to just get these survivors down, but spawn's kind of a little haphazard here.
Attack will be up in just a moment. There it is. And given the state in health, we might see the survivors just decide to try and run forward, although there is a car there as well, so that's going to make things very difficult for them.
Let's take that over to the Coalition Cool Kids. We'll hear them play against the tank.
He's pushing it in. Oh, jumpy man. Well, I didn't think you all were up there.
And there you have it. Tank making easy work with one single car. Wow. Let's have a look at that again. Yeah, that's how you do it. Let's have a look at that on the instant replay. You can see Tank maneuvering in here on the replay, getting car into position. I think it's going to be two more smacks, and this is going to be one more hit right after this, and it's going to be everybody down from that car. Wow, what an attack. Be back with the rest of the round shortly. Round is going live here for our first attack. We're going to have a Jockey Charger Smoker Boomer. We're going to watch the Squid Squad and see how well they can do against the infected team here. Boomer spawning in, getting a single boom. Jockey also attacking, trying to separate the survivors. Great charge there. Nice double charge. Empathy taking a lot of damage, as well as Grim, actually. We've got... damage going out. Excuse me, Empathy's on, was the charger. Empathy doling out the damage to Grim and Brightness in that double charge.
Pretty well played by the SI there. And they went in early enough to now be able to hit on this little mini choke point here on the bus.
Jockey has spawned up already. Boomer spawning up, getting a nice double boom. Jockey coming in from the back. Smoker also getting that pull, gets M2'd shut down right away. Jockey gonna cover that Hunter. He's hopping around looking for a target, but he gets shut down, melee before he can do anything. Smoker getting a pull back, but again, more damage going out on Grim. Ramirez taking some chip there. Brightness also, actually everyone on the team taking a fair amount of chip. So two good attacks by the Coalition of Cool Kids.
Yeah, and they need to, as I said last round actually, they need to hold on to their help a little bit here, because that tank can, once they get there, can sit behind his car and bleed them for a while before he attacks. Unless, of course, he decides to just punch it and kill them all at the same time, in which case,
help and
kills will not be effective.
The separation here, Smoker getting a pull way in the back while Charger attacking up in front. Survivors not minding their distance here, and they were made to pay for it. We've got a down on Grim, no more health for him, only pills remaining for Grim, and Brightness also bleeding out there. So some really nice attacks here by the Coalition of Cool Kids.
Yeah, they really capitalized on Grim being totally by himself in the house there, with his survivor teammates being a little bit back further away, too far to clear him quickly.
And here comes our next attack. We've got a Smoker, Jockey, Spitter, Charger. Charger running away. Spitter trying to get away too. Don't know if he's going to make it, and did not. Charge goes out on nothing. Charger's still up, but he's going to get shut down through that wall. And that is it for the attack. I'm not sure. Maybe a little bit of miscommunication on that attack. Nonetheless, I think in that previous attack, what actually happened was Smoker was able to pull Rochelle back, and all the teammates except Grim went back to get that clear, thus leaving him separated. And Charger took advantage of that. Survivor's now jumping down the hole here.
And that's why it's important to communicate and say, hey, look, I'm gonna clear the smoker, don't come with me. And that could have been avoided.
Reloading!
Survivors, making it up. Team, Mentor, I'm sorry, that's Grim, up on top already. Nice double boom going out, two survivors coated in purple. SI coming up from the tunnel. Smoker gets shut down right away. Jockey not able to land. Also, Hunter dead as well. So actually very good take there by the Squid Squad. Here comes the crown. Beautiful speed crown there by Grim. And he shoots a car for some reason. Or
that was a very interesting reversal of the choke point there. Usually the survivors have to go through and funnel in all from the same direction, allowing the SI to hit them more easily. By that time, the SI decided to come from below and actually got destroyed because they were all coming through that tiny little hole.
Yes, very interesting analysis. A nice reversal of the choke. New attack coming out here. Boomer getting a single boom on Brightness along with a proxy on her as well. Brightness electing to commit pills. Almost in full bleed. Only two sets of pills remaining. But the survivor's in better shape than was the Coalition Cool Kids at this point.
Oh god, something exploded. You see that?
Yes, that's the bridge. I guess we'll have to visit that. The bridge explodes.
Oh,
Tank is now up in the hands of Cygnus. We're going to take this actually over to a survival worm because that's what we did last time. So we're going to listen to the Squid Squad play against this tank.
Hi, car. She's going to hit me and I'm going to cry.
Crazy.
Why? Always me. Fuck you, Tank.
Shoot it! Shoot it! Okay. Oh, fuck!
Send me
you!
Kill the tank!
He's dead.
Oh, he's
dead? Oh. Skill is. Nice. Weapon. I got the kill.
Close the brightness.
Oh, nice take by Ramirez's Squid Squad. Tank able to land a couple of good punches there. Oh, we got a pullback, almost an end cap there on Brightness. Jockey coming in trying to cover, but too late. Sorry.
Seemed like a pretty good idea by the tank there. We kind of left the car on that one side of the ambulance and then looped around without taking it with him to try to push the survivors around in a circle and then towards the car, and it almost worked. Unfortunately, one of the survivors was able to juke him, and he missed a couple of punches. And then by the time he got back around to the car, he didn't have enough health left to give it a good whack. Guitar here.
Next hit up will be a Hunter, Spitter, Charger, Smoker, survivors rounding the, are working their way through the cemetery. And here comes the attack. Charger lands a beautiful double charge. Hunter also lands with Spit. Actually, Spit went down on the charge, but isn't there anymore. More damage on Grim and Brightness, but not so much on the health bonus. And that's where they need to focus. I think with this, Ramirez is actually going to pull ahead here, the Squid Squad.
You may be right. By quite a lot, actually.
And they have made it into the safe room with a respectable health bonus. That will give them a 200 point lead here now. Scores of 18.
200 points behind to 200 points ahead now.
So nicely played by the Squid Squad. That's the score of 1869 to 1689. The Coalition of Cool Kids. We'll be back with the rest of the match short. Alright, we are back here with the next map in the Parish campaign. We've got Ramirez's Squid Squad ahead by 1875 to 1689 for the Coalition of Cool Kids. First hit will be a Spitter Jockey, Smoker, and Charger. Smoker spawned up going for a pull. That tongue gets cut. Rest of the SI spawning up, unfortunately relying on that Smoker, and he was not able to land. Charger does land, gets cleared right away. Spit going down on that charge. That's going to be some little bit of chip there. Actually, quite a bit of chip on Grim. And rest of the survivors making it through unscathed.
Yeah, in spite of the spit not spreading particularly well in the safe room, Grim was perfectly positioned to take lots of damage there.
We now have a tank up in the hands of Easy. We're going to go over to an infected worm and listen to them play their tank.
Are you ready?
She's got a boomer.
You're shooting me. Wait, are you going now?
No, it is sack.
The boomer now goes.
Yeah, sack boomer.
Would you want me to go on knee when I get the boomer? Please shoot me, I'm going.
Nice.
Yeah, ready?
Yeah.
I'll let the ward come.
Nice.
The punch is easy.
Use those long arms.
I got your help in a second. Keep going, Easy.
Nice. Get that double punch.
Let's shut that up then. There we go.
Good coach.
Good job.
Time to punch his man.
So, there you have it. Damage given out, and some of it. Not. Lack of better phrasing.
Extremely comprehensive.
Well, we've got two survivors bleeding and two not bleeding, so.
That is true. That was a pretty good tank. He came in there. He took a little bit of chip through the wall, unfortunately, which shortened his stay in the room before committing.
He did miss a couple of punches there. One of the survivors was able to jump over him on the stairs. And he missed another punch, I think, in the corner there when he turned around trying to get a double. Next hit is up here. We've got a pull. Charger's going to go in on that. He's getting some punches. Going for that charge. He gets shut down before he's able to complete the charge. Spitter goes unable to get anything with that spit. Go ahead.
The smoker actually got a really good pull there. Unfortunately, the charger decided to put himself between the smoke and the survivor. So he wanted to get those punches, but if he had moved out of the way for a second, then the pull would have gone completely into the room, and he could have probably covered that a little bit better. Still good damage.
Yeah, we've got two survivors in full bleed. Grim going to have to commit a set of pills here. He's at no HP. Jockey coming, gonna get the down on him. I'm not sure why he didn't commit pills there to avoid that, but Spit going down on that along with the Jockey. That's gonna be a lot of damage on Brightness as well. Chipping away at her permanent health. So nice attack there by the Coalition of Cool Kids.
Yeah, lots of damage down. They managed to land on the health bonus. So coming into the holdout event here, survivors only have one set of pills. Unless they find more, in which case they'll have more than one. I hear a witch crying also. Oh?
I think witch is outside on the balcony. She is.
She sounds upset.
Very agitated. Not happy. We're going to have a boomer, smoker, charger, and spitter to try and agitate her a little more while the survivors make their way towards her. And charger coming and doing just that. Aggravating that witch.
We may of course see her once she does aggro fully just run off in a different direction to the survivors as well as possible.
Oh, she may in fact run all the way to the other safe room. Preparation, and here she comes. She's smacking the common. Yep, teaching them a lesson. And here she comes, and a nice crown again by Ramirez.
Good team play from the witch there, killing some common to allow the survivors a little breathing room.
Well, you know. Oh, what a fantastic jockey there, getting it down on team captain Ramirez. He is out of the match, unless they can get back there and get that pickup on the railing. Sometimes you can, sometimes it doesn't work. We'll see what happens here. Jockey riding Ellis over here in the corner. Got to be taking him for a little ride, and he is almost down. This does not look good for the Squid Squad. We've got two players down, only Brightness and Ike up. Charger coming in, going for punches on Coach, and Coach able to get that level. Nice job by Ike. Boomer coming in, going to shut down probably the rest of this. Oh my goodness, with a proxy. Boom, that's all three survivors. Boom. Going to be tough to get this pickup now. Now we've got two down. This may very well be the end. Spitter going to come in and probably end this right now. And that is the end, folks. Great play there by the Coalition of Cool Kids.
Yeah, really well done. I think they managed to... Oh, they didn't manage to get the survivors down before the holdout bonus went through, unfortunately. So survivors do get those extra 39 points. But no more distance.
Having a look at the end of that round again on the instant replay, some nice work there by the Coalition of Cool Kids. Be back with the rest of the round shortly. All right, Sprout, we are back here. Round is going live. For our first hit, we will have a Spitter, Jockey, Charger, and Smoker. It's time for the Coalition of Cool Kids to give it a shot at playing Survivor and see if they can get back the lead in this game.
I think it's going to be a Brightness tank, right? She's the only one that hasn't had one so far.
Honestly, I have not been... paying attention to who has and who has not. Yes, that is correct. Attack coming in. Great charge into the spit there. Nice job getting shut down, though, but Cygnus taking a lot of damage from that spit, so nice attack by the Squid Squad. But the remaining survivor is relatively unscathed. Tank is now up in the hands of Brightness. Good call there. So we will take this over to an infected war room and hear them play their tank.
Yeah, don't face that way. Turn around.
Oh, okay,
I can see your fist through the wall.
Yeah, you're getting like that.
Do you want me to burn the smoker?
No, we're gonna burn it. I think you should just commit.
Alright, okay.
We'll get your back. 3-3.
Help her out.
Yeah, help her out.
Help her out.
Oh, fuck me.
My god.
That's well.
Nice.
Spread it, spread.
Good spread.
Good damage.
I should have connected. That was good.
Fuck. Try to free the jockey guy. That would have been really good. My fault.
Everybody getting punched there by Brightness's tank. Really good work.
Yep. Yeah. Spreading it out.
Support actually came in really late, it seemed like to me.
Me as well. You need support right away with that tank. Yeah, he just gets burgered. Chip the shit immediately. That is a technical term, folks. Next stack is up. We've got a jockey, Boomer, Charger, and I believe Spitter. And that Boomer already popped. We've got Jockey still up here, Charger and Spitter as well. And here comes the Jockey. This is what you want to see here. Charger not in position here to capitalize on this. I don't know what the Charger was doing, but he missed out on that attack.
Good effort there, trying to get the jockey and then immediately followed by the spit to spit block the survivors from coming up the stairs and getting that clear. Unfortunately, survivors were too quick on the uptake there and managed to get into the pool room. And like you said, Charger never appeared.
Yeah, unfortunately, Squid Squad missing out on an opportunity there to get a lot of damage with separation and a charge in spit while one of the other survivors being jockeyed away, I think may have been the plan. We've got the witch to deal with now, and Boomer has spawned up on that witch, helping The boomer out will be a smoker, charger, and hunter. Boomer giving the witch something to look at, and she is actually looking right at it. Here comes the boom, gets a nice single boom. Boomer gets popped, but does not trigger the witch for whatever reason. Here comes the draw crown. Witch has lost her mind thanks to the charger who punched her. Witch now cannot figure out what to do. Most unfortunate for for the squid squad.
Thanks, witch.
And we have seen a lot of goofy witches in this particular campaign. I don't know if it's just Left 4 Dead 2 in general or just this campaign. Never mind. It is Left 4 Dead 2 in general, folks. It happens a lot, especially in Pro Mod.
Yeah. Popping aside, when the boomer explodes on the witch like that, you'd think that she'd get angry immediately, but she did not seem to care at all.
Apparently not. So we have a nice tri-boom going out. Smoker getting a pull on the driver who is not boomed. Boomer is still up here. Maybe going for a proxy, not able to do anything with it. Nice try, but we've got survivors really not in too good shape here. Everybody bleeding, and no pills remaining. We're going to be looking.
Cygnus misses the jump onto the float there, so he's reset. He has to make his way all the way around again while the SI timers are ticking down, and they're going to be able to set up another hit before survivors manage to fully cross over to the other building here.
They've got a charger, hunter, and jockey ready to do some work here, and a spitter. Unfortunately, no smoker for that reset, but we've seen a beautiful charge here by some of the other teams getting a charge and almost able to do it. Lands the charge, but not able to get the survivor off the platform. Hunter comes in, but we do have a jockey in the back for another reset on Cygnus. He's going to have to go through the stairs again, through the stairwell.
Ellis got really lucky there not to get incapped. He was in spit, but the hunter pounced him just at the right time to give him god frames, and he walked out on his two legs instead of being picked up by one of his teammates.
So the Squid Squad not looking to give up their lead at all. We've got a down now on Luke, and Boomer goes in, misses the boom.
What a pop. That bomb, it looked like it went all over the survivors.
It did. What a dead stop there by Easy. Fantastic job there, shutting down that hunter. I hate to interrupt you, but that was beautiful.
That was very well played, and they're making some really good distance here in spite of the fact that they have barely any health left. And they're going to come up to a pill cabinet, which looks like it's got one pill in it. Yes.
Better than none. So the Coalition of Cool Kids really trying to get this lead, get their lead back. This is a very close game now at 2160 to 2292. Making up a lot of points here.
Sorry, I agree with you that one pill is better than none. Would you say, in your opinion, that two is even better?
I would, actually. Nice attack there with double cap, almost a tri-cap. We've got, actually, it is a tri-cap. Only one survivor up. That is easy. Getting the pickup on his teammates. A great attack by the Squid Squad, but not quite enough to get all the downs. But this common chipping away at Easy's little bit of health here. Easy rocking that one HP. And he's already had one in cap. Or actually, no in caps. I'm not sure why the survivors aren't downing him yet. But probably waiting for this next attack, because it's going to happen. Here comes the jockey getting the down on Easy. Nice job by the jockey. And we've got a down in the back. Only one survivor up. This smoker's going to get the pull. That'll be the end for the survivors up on top here. Unfortunately.
And because the jockey managed to get that scratch and down easy. And right when that happened, two of the survivors dropped down. So they weren't able to clear the remaining survivor. I think it was Cygnus.
Yeah, survivors not minding their health bonus. Here comes Luke trying to shut everything down. He's going to get smoked. And Charger there as well to add a little slip of injury. But we have a 42-point game here, folks. Excuse me. We have the Coalition of Cool Kids pulling ahead. Thanks to that Witch Crown, 23-10 to 22-92. And we will be back with the rest of this very close game right after this. We'll be right back. All right, Sprout, we are back. Actually, what a great run there by the Coalition of Cool Kids. Thought we could talk about that for a little bit while I wait for ready ups.
Let's talk about that.
Shall we?
Really good run.
Luke
made it farther than the other team.
Yes, that being the object of the game, point and click zombie racing game, that is what you do.
Goal achieved.
Luke opting to run ahead when his remaining teammates were down. Of course, no point in him actually trying to get the pickups on those two. It wouldn't have happened.
No, and regardless of whether there was a point or not, it is his trademark move, as he talked about earlier today in a different game. He likes to hold W.
There you go. Alright, the round is going live here for our first attack. We've got a Charger, Jockey, Spitter, Hunter attack coming in right away because we're going to have an early tank. That Hunter getting skeeted, Jockey shut down as well. Charger landing a few punches on Empathy, along with Spit going down.
So here we have the fence tank. Oh, are you moving us?
Yes. We've got a tank in the hands of Brightness. We're going to go ahead and listen to the survivors play against this tank.
Whoa! What?
What?
Shotgun out of the
way. I got a safe room.
Here we go.
OMG!
Just jump when he goes for a punch.
Fold.
I still need to be cleared.
Is so
easy. Thank you, Luke.
Oh my
kill
god,
tank,
the
kill tank, kill tank.
The semi jukes.
Kill tank, kill tank, kill tank.
Never mind.
Alright, good job. We lived. That's all that matters.
Semi jukes.
So Luke is screaming about Simi Jukes while he's getting down by the tank. So a nice tank there by Brightness, not able to get the wipe. Unfortunately, SI did come in and support her very well, as a matter of fact.
Yeah, a little bit of bad timing for the tank, though, because she kind of started moving towards the survivors as the bridge neared the bottom. But she arrived at that little ramp thing right before it dropped down and actually got stuck on there for a second.
We've got a Jockey going on up in front here. Smoker got shut down in the back by Rochelle. Jockey is now cleared as well. We've got three survivors in bleed. Cygnus with actually the most permanent health remaining. Empathy and Easy trailing. Luke with none at this point. No pills left to commit. So a Coalition of Cool Kids making their way up to this next tank area. And Luke hangs himself on the 18-wheeler. We have the next attack up in the form of a Spitter, Hunter, Smoker, Charger. They're going to be looking for a death charge maybe into this hole here. Spit going down. A little bit of spit block there. Oh, what a fantastic pull. Charger going to go for that death charge, and that is it for Luke. Goodbye, sir. We will see you in the next tournament. Nice attack there. Very well done by Ramirez of Squid Squad. Setting up that death charge and separating the survivors with Spit.
So survivors probably aiming to get as much distance as they can here. We're in a similar situation to map 3, I think it was, where the survivors need to make distance along kind of a narrow passageway, but there is a car and a tank in between them and safe room.
And you see the tack coming in there with a boom and Spit on Easy, I think Easy getting the accidental level while Boom just waving that machete around at everything like a madman and pulling off that level. So kudos to him. We've got it down now on Coach. That is Empathy. This will be the first in cap. Drivers unfortunately have no pills. Easy is in full bleed with no pills to commit either. Only Cygnus with any permanent health. Tank is now up. And this tank will be controlled by Ica, but we may not even get there, folks, because they've got a Jockey attacking, getting some scratches on Cygnus. Still has some permanent health. Tank committing and committing right now. We can just go ahead and call out the rest of this. There's a smoke going out on Coach. Only one survivor up at this point. Tank just needs to get there and finish this up. There's the punch. And either a rock or one more punch on Coach and we'll be done. And there it is. So that's going to leave the Coalition of Cool Kids with a score of 26-34. And now we will see the Squid Squad try to beat that.
It's a distance game now. Just like we saw with Rails, Vaneki, and Dank side of the
Pooch.
Yeah, they're very, very close, and they need to survive this initial tank, and then just make it basically to the spot where the second tank spawns. Assuming they have all four survivors alive at that point, they will take the lead.
Yeah, this is actually very close to what we saw. And the last game, with a very, very close game there as well, with Vaneki, like you say, versus Dank side of the Pooch. But we're going to see if Ramirez of Squid Squad can get the win here over the Coalition of Cool Kids. This would be their first win of the tournament if they can manage to stop the Squid Squad. Attack is coming in. We've got a Hunter, Spinner, Jockey, Charger. They're committing right away at the safe room door. Hunter gets shut down immediately. Spit going in, Charger just standing there, I'm not sure, waiting. He gets leveled, but a fantastic level by Ika. Jockey still standing there, waiting for his attack. Jockey coming in and gets M2'd and shut down. What a great take there by the Squid Squad. Excellently played. And we've got a tank up in the hands of Luke, and looking for his revenge, possibly. So let's go on over to a survivor worm and hear them play against this tank.
Oh, I love you. Oh, you pushed me off. I'm so sad.
Oh, my fault. Get back up quick.
No!
There's a rock coming from. Oh. I'm watching the back.
Alright, watch the front, watch the front. I'm watching the back.
Rock.
Let's move!
Forward. Smoker behind.
Super chat, he's in.
Charger behind.
Pulled. Oh.
Pounced. Team.
There's so much room.
I'm dead.
Holy shit. No boom required.
GG.
And there it is, folks. We are back. The Coalition of Cool Kids getting their first win. Luke getting his revenge for that death charge. Moral of the story, don't piss off Luke and death charge him. Very well played tank by Luke, not missing any punches, getting in some nice doubles in the corner there. And there it is, everybody who called it, that the Coalition of Cool Kids had no chance. You were wrong, folks.
Extremely wrong.
But wow, what a match. That was a very close game, and very well played by both teams. Unfortunately, we have that little bit of that issue with the tank on fire. Maybe hearing about that later on. Don't know if that's going to factor into anything that's going on here, but at this point, we're going to go ahead and say the Cool Kids have won the match. Congrats, guys.
Now, you do you know whether this will affect the standings in any way, or...
Actually, I defer to Fish for all of that. I don't actually know where that will place them, but I'm sure we're going to find out tomorrow or later on tonight on the forum. So, again, for everybody watching, if you have not, you can check out tfpgforums.com to get the latest information on TFPG, as well as follow our tournament, find out the standings, watch the highlights, past matches, all of the video on demand links are listed there as well. So with that, Sprout, I'm going to wrap this up, call it a night, unless there's anything else you'd like to add.
No, I don't think so. I enjoyed the game, though, and thanks for casting with me.
Well, thank you for casting with me as well, sir, and I appreciate it. And with that, I will let you go. Thank you so much. And
See you later.
Yes, sir. With that, everybody, I'm going to go ahead and end the stream here. Before I let you go, though, if you have not followed the stream, please do. If you are not a member of Montclair's Lair, have not joined the Steam group, you can get the link to that. It is listed beneath the video. Make sure you join that group to get notifications. notifications for upcoming TFPG events and when I will be streaming. And with that, we will say goodbye to the Swiss portion of the TFPG Spring Tournament for 2015. We'll have the semifinals bracket up for you, or matches up for you next week, and then after that, the finals. So thank you, everyone, for watching. I hope you had a good time. I am Montclair, and I will see you next time.